The economy is on life support. I don't know. Is that life support there or there? It's too fragile. $600 a week. You think Congress is going to remove that $600 a week? If you think the rioting is bad now, you wait until you take that money out of the hands of our children. Actually, let me do this. My daughter's downstairs. Let me scream at her, and I'm just going to put her right on camera, and let's see what her answer is. Hey, McKenna, I need you to come up here. This is my daughter, McKenna. She's shy on camera. How much is that a month that you make on unemployment?
I make...
With everything and babysitting.
With nannying once a week, I make over $3,500 a month. From unemployment with no degree or anything.
And what are you gonna, what's gonna happen when they take it away?
I'll be upset because I don't want to go back to work at all.
And Wall Street is warning corporate America. They're yelling at them. They're like, hey, America, get the cash while you can. So if you thought it was bad before, the money grab has just started. And coming in from BMO, that's an investment firm, a big macro company. I do a lot in macroeconomics. I like to know like big picture, but they polled everyone. They're like, hey, so where is all this money coming from? And 75%, 73% said that this is a Fed-driven show. This is Jerome Powell's game. He's running everything. I don't know why I just grabbed my fishing pole. I guess he's fishing. And coming in from Forex Live, they're telling you to buy everything. It's different this time, you know? You hear that mantra? It's different this time. It's always different this time. It was like last New Year's resolution where you're like, that's it. The game's over. I'm gonna lose that 10 pounds. Is that vanilla? Welcome back to my channel where I have vanilla ice cream all over my nose because my daughter does not know how to hand me ice cream. But if you like a channel that talks about stonks and money and investing and all that kind of good stuff and lighthearted, okay? Just a nice channel where we have a good time. We're very sarcastic in the comments section. We actually love one another. Would you at least just consider subscribing? So this coming in from Bloomberg, U.S. economy. It's too fragile for Congress to remove income support. Can't do it, man. I'm telling you, you know, when government programs start, you just can't take them away. And here it is, $600 a week. Ugh, jobless payments expiring in July may dampen the rebound. Yes, it will dampen the rebound. Absolutely. That is part of the gross domestic product is you guys getting out there and spending those digits. Lawmakers debate plans including back to work bonuses instead. If you go back to work, this is what we'll do. We'll give you a big surprise. You want to know where the surprise is going to be? Is when all these people that have all this time off, you know, they're not running corporations. They have some free time to do what they do. I live here in LA, so you know what they're currently doing right now? A lot of free time is they don't want to go back to work. I mean, heck, you're getting three. So as you guys know, I have six. One of my kids is getting over $4,000 a month on unemployment. She worked two jobs, bartending. Do you really think that she wants to go back to that? And dear audience, I just need to let you know right now, I have trained my kids up, God-fearing kids, get a job, work hard, love people. And then I lead by example, and I'm like, go get a job, work hard. And they're like, but I get $4,200 a month, and I really don't want to go back to work. So I kind of get it, right? You understand that it would be nice just to stay at home and take the paycheck. And after approving the most generous, yeah, I'd say that's most generous benefits in United States history, because of that bad word, let's get rid of that. Congress is in a bind over what to do and when to expire, which this is expiring in July. Well, I'll tell you what they're going to do. It's politicians. And if you remove the cheese, you don't get elected and you don't get the vote. So you're like, well, just let them keep the cheese. And here is your weekly unemployment claims that the Treasury is making. Look at that right above my head. We are, the sky's the limit, and yeah, that's, you guys see that tapering. I'm not seeing no V shape. I'm not seeing this thing coming down a little bit. I could see a little bit, but I don't think that the lawmakers are going to want to go. Everyone's cut off. And that means that weeks of wrangling. So it looks like our government is now in the cowboy, cowgirl business. But I'm going to place my bets on the government protecting itself and saying, yeah, we'll go ahead and just kind of extend that for another 30 days. We'll see what they come up with, but I'm just not feeling it. And guys, if you're like, yeah, make those kids go back to McDonald's or whatever, the amount of, if you were to take the percentages of where all of this cheese is going, it's going to the corporations, okay? This is another corporations thing. This is not the people. It never has been, actually. Again, coming in from Bloomberg, Wall Street warning corporate America, get them cash while you can. And I know a lot of my friends in court, I own corporations, but my businesses aren't like, I can't do it. I don't know, morally, ethically, but a lot of my friends are just, woo, I got this free cheese and this money and I promise to pay it all back. Bankers urge companies, good old bankers, raise debt. And I mean, that's what this entire system is just debt. So corporations raise debt. And then they take that debt and they buy assets with it. And then the Fed's like, oh, we'll go ahead and take that debt off of your hands. You didn't need that. Uber, among those borrowing to add cash to their balance sheet. So what are the rich doing? And JP Morgan Asset Management, maybe they have some advice for us.
Well, this is amazing. And John, what's so important here is I'm part of that $5 trillion of cash. It's a good feeling, John.
Except your cash is staying there, Tom, and it's not going anywhere anytime soon, I'm sure. Phil, let's talk about that $5 trillion of cash in money market funds. How much of that is just companies that have borrowed an absolute fortune and have had to park the cash before they draw it down?
And coming in from BMO, capitalmarkets.bmo.com, good podcast. You guys may want to take a look at their, I'm a macro guy, but I'm an everything guy. And I almost feel like, because as you know, I'm a contrarian. Well, I try to be a contrarian, but with everyone and their mother and their mother's friend's best friend thinking that this is 100%, 70, actually, I'm going to get to this article, 73% believe that this is a Fed driven market by our friend Jay. What's driving this market? And BMO, their strategist, they sent this out to everyone and they came up with what is driving a swift recovery in equities? What are equities? Those are stocks. 73% said it is the Fed. Earnings, you know, we're forward looking. We're looking at these earnings. 0%. Labor market recovery, we will recover. This V-shape says 6%, so not too much. Further fiscal stimulus, 5%, and progress in we're not preventing, we're not treating up. Just kiss that one goodbye. That's 6%. Everything's been a failure on that front. And then you have good old other. So there you go. Where are you? I mean, are you earnings? Like, it's Fed. Dang, I want to be, help me not be so darn with everyone else and all the bankers thinking that this has been, will be a Fed-driven market. What else could it be? And here's something interesting about the respondents. When will the Fed announce yield curve control? Oh, okay. Now just, you know, working on one side, we're going to work on the entire yield curve within 3 months, 21%, 3 to 6 months. I mean, so basically, at some point in the next 12 months, the Fed will handle the entire bond market and the yield. And I think I got to put my glasses on for that one and say, what the fire truck? That is just crazy. And for those of you that know or don't know, the bond market is bigger than the stock market, bigger than equities. If you were to like cut this guy, you know, in half? Now this is like, what would this be? This over here is the bond market, and this right here is the stock market. And this just in, breaking news, if you can make it to the end or close to the end, I'm going to give you a little secret, little stock market trading pattern. I don't want to give it all away. It has to do with those little bars that go up and down and the pretty colors. So stay tuned to the close to the end. So because I want this channel to be about helping you, not just giving you, woo, scary news, you know, complaining kids. Well, do we have a solution? That's what I want. I want a solution. How can I make some more Monopoly money? Because you want to win Monopoly, just like the Fed. And I also want to look at SAVA, Sava. I gave recommendations about a week ago. I can't recommend anything. It's not financial advice. You will lose all of this stuff if you listen to me. 100% plus another 1,000 if you decide to, you know, play the long game. So again, never take this as financial advice, but you guys reached out in the comments section. You're like, oh my gosh, I made 65% on Sava. And there was HPQ, but guys, you can't buy and hodl. You'll lose your money. You got to take the money off the table. Like Kenny Rogers says, know when to fold them, know when to walk away.
You got to know when to hold them, when to hold them, know when to fold them, know when to walk away. And if you're married, know when to run. There'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done.
Please know that I only make a complete idiot out of myself just to make you smile, or at least to click the like button. So if you can, that's been kind of a rule. I'm like, if I can make you just laugh one time, just to giggle, you'd hit that. The simple case, it's just a simple case, coming in from Forex Live. For all of you that want to lose all your money, make sure that you buy someone's course on minute trading penny stocks. And then this article is like classic, and this guy, Adam Button. All right, Adam Button, the simple case for buying everything right now. Hurry up, buy it all, suspend your disbelief, and embrace the money. The money future, kids. It's not going to go away. It's just going to be forever. They don't want to sucker. You know, those old people, they don't know what's going on. You kids know what the frack is going. You know what's going down. It's like, yes, the roaring 20s, man. 1928. All over again, and if I could just zoom in on this guy's face. Ah, I wish you guys could. Can I get this? Oh, it's just this classic, like, it's all good. And out of this group of kids, gentlemen, which one of these tools gets the most chicks? Is it dude, is it simp number one, number two, or number three? I will tell it to you right now. You could, if you want to pause the video and then have your wife come over, your girlfriend, and pick which one of the three, I will tell you right now which one she will pick. 80% of my audience, as polled, will pick this guy, and I will tell you why, because he is the tallest. Tallest always wins. And second thing women look for is right there. It's called a smile. So if you don't got a smile, gentlemen, make sure you get yourself one of them. So, since I know this channel is like 90-100% dudes, if you want, let's just see if I'm right on this one. You can pause the video, you can go get your girlfriend, go get your wife, and just like, hey, number one, number two, or number three. I'm pretty darn sure that we're gonna have an 80% number three, but leave a comment. That's a pretty easy comment, right? You just smash a number one, two, or three, but I'm going with number three. And if for some reason she's like, well, I can't judge based on looks, give number one the most money, okay? Number one has the most money out of all. They say, well, Johnny Bravo, these are the only things that he knows. Number one has the most money. So whatever your question is, number one has the most money. I just have to trip at this story. The enthusiasm in markets at the moment, borderline euphoria. Retail is pouring into the flavor of the day, and now FOMO is taking over. What are you doing? You got to decide right now. You coming into this market, or are you just going to go run away like a little baby? Fiscal conservatism is dead. We don't need to be responsible. We could just spend. There is no consequences. It's free money. Take that money and buy the world. And this is a wholesale generational secular change. This $8 trillion, you know, they're just going to keep going. This is forever. Deficits don't matter anymore. You don't have to worry about it. Come on, kids. Let's all just pour into this market. As Warren Buffett is sitting there, like the 90-year-old, happy birthday, Warren, that he is, or almost is, this year, soon, right now, depending on when you're watching this video, he's like, I got to win this game. I got to win the game of Monopoly, man. Blood in the streets. Come on, we're going to get there before my last breath. And then he's going to step in with his bazillions and just buy it all and be like, I won. And there will be a reckoning, and it will mean currency debasement. I'm kind of excited. I did book. I don't know if you guys have heard the dollar milkshake theory. He has agreed to come onto the channel. Me and my team of one was like, please, please, I beg of you, come on. So that will be next week. You're like, ah, you're actually not a complete idiot, Johnny Bravo. You may have a couple brain cells and low rates forever. And there's Jerome showing you the size again. The guy always wants to brag. Dang it, Jerome, you have me beat every time. I should try that when I'm out. Hey, babe. It's like that. I'm married, but my wife doesn't watch this anyways. So that's what I say to my wife. Hey, babe. Hey, babe. Yep. Wink, wink. And because this is a PG channel, you can, kids, I'm talking about my wallet. That's it. That's the size. That is the size and thinness of my wallet. That's all I'm referring to because my wife actually likes this better than she liked. I'll just stop with it now. I can't imagine what the comment section is going to look like tonight. And then, like I said, if you waited to the end, hopefully we're at the end. This guy has over a million, I think 2 million views on this. It's called the 3-bar play. Charlie's gone over it before in his course. You got an igniting, and it can go both ways. Do you guys see this red bar? I kind of went a little big on that one. That is your very, very first bar. That is an igniting bar. Your next bar is a baby bar, just like that. And this goes up and down. And then your last bar right there. And that is your 3-bar play. And you enter the position on the 3rd bar. I mean, look at the money on the way down on this one. This went from 15 to 11 bucks. And I thought I'd be able to get some images, but these are like all videos. But on this, you also have a 4-bar play. We're sticking with the 3-bar play. This is on the upside. Again, you have an igniting candle, and I'm gonna go into Trading View. Probably won't be able to find one because it's kind of difficult to find. I mean, unless you're maybe trading 1 minute. And then you have a baby bar, and you wanna be really careful. These two bars, you want them to meet just like that. Make it look like that. And then this one, you are in the money, honey. Same thing with a 4-bar play. Kind of the same look. You got long and then you have short. So you can flip it going down. You lose your shorts and you can flip it going up. And I also found a website, News Honda. I don't know what any of this says, but I'm looking for an image here. Here you go. One candle up. Baby bar, make sure your wicks, you don't want a big fat baby with long wicks. This is the candle. Those other things are the wicks. And then your last one. So this one ignites it. You want a big, fat, juicy igniter that's like, woo, we're going to the moon. And then this one just kind of goes, I don't know. We're just going to relax, consolidate right here. Give me just a moment. And then the next one, we are off to the moon with a Lambo. Now we're going to take a look at this bar play. Now you might be looking at this and you're like, oh, there it is. It's on Sava on the 1 minute. You know, when it reopens tomorrow, we're higher highs, Johnny Bravo. No, I'll tell you what's the fit. There's a few fails on this 3-bar play. Do you guys see this green long bar? That would be your igniting bar. You want a big fat juicy igniting bar. This is not a big fat juicy igniting bar. And then you want a resting bar that's just chilling. It's consolidating. And then the 3rd bar play, that is where you come in and you were to put in a stop loss, okay? That's what you always want to put in one of these because you want to stop lossing your money. This is not a buy and hold old channel. You got all those other ones on YouTube. Just type in dividend investing for beginners and just, you know what? Grab all of those stonks and because they have dividends until they cut the dividends. And you're like, wait, so I bought the stonk for $100 and now it's a dollar. But that YouTuber says it has a dividend. Is that a good idea? And on this Sava stock, I want to show you how this trade would play out. Here's one, right? It's one candle close above. You're going to ride that, you know, until you feel like it's time to take some money off of the table. But definitely one candle close below. And then we have another swing down and you're like, whoop, Where'd my chart go? And that is where my Johnny Peeps audience are like, oh, here it is. And that's why they were hitting me up in the comment section. Put in a buy at anywhere here, 227, and just ride this all the way up, 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 and away. And that's, you know, that is how the game is played. It's based on momentum. I like momentum, and I do not like buying and holding. And like I, what I said, my son-in-law, he's like, yeah, I took some money off the table. I closed my position on this one. Let's say you were to get in there and you closed it there. I mean, only a narcissist would say that they were the one dude that, you know, scored 69 on that one. Wait, am I off by one? Let me just try that one more time. We're at the bottom and we are at the top, which is 72%. Don't think you did that, but that is that play. It is based on momentum. And then again, we're going to come down. We're going to go below the 20. That is that red line that you see right there. But you want it to go down. Like when I, on Sea-Doos, you take out the front and you could dip that thing down underneath the water. I almost busted my face open in the ocean. Do never do that. Down underneath, you come up, and then you break your face clearly wide open, and then you get the next momentum move. So hopefully you guys took some money off of the table on Sava. And if this stuff seems interesting, if you're a dude and you want to just sit home all day long and day trade, I can't do it. ZipTraderU offers you guys 10%, supports the channel. So take a look at it somewhere down that way. And I've going through the course too. I understand most of it, but it's nice, you know, some principles. I'm like, you got me on that one. But you guys know me. I'm a business guy. Oh, another order coming in. Hold on. Where we take this off and we're like, oh, okay, cool. And then you could like pay someone to do it, or you can do it. But I like bringing products that actually really hurt. I will never do that again. Woo! If you ladies, you know, if you ever want to look a lip, oh my gosh, that's some hair there. But I will leave a link in the description if you guys want to learn how to start businesses online. 80 videos. I give you guys a coupon code that's ridiculous. Normally it's $1,300 for the two courses. I give it to you for 190 something, so 90-ish percent off. Take a look at it. There's always a couple codes, but they go quick, so grab them, and I will see you tomorrow.